Ready to simplify your development process? In today's video, we'll walk you through the straightforward step to set up a classic build pipeline in Azure DevOps and create a resource on Azure. So let's get started. Hey, welcome back. In this video, we are going to continue with our Azure DevOps series, and this time we'll focus on designing and implementing a pipeline. We're going to use our Phoenix project, which we previously created, but this time we need to import a repository that contains a simple application that we will use for testing our pipeline throughout this series. This is a demo.net app, which we've mentioned in earlier video. So let's go ahead and import the repository. First, we need to use the URL and paste it and add it there. And by default, the app is called demo.net app, but we are going to rename it to smart app. And then once that's done, you click import. The repository will start importing, so we just need to wait a little bit and it should be done shortly. Now it's successfully imported. Let's go back to our repository and check. We can see all the files and folder have been imported correctly, so everything looks good. Next up, we are going to start implementing the pipeline and working with it. So before we create a pipeline, we first need to set up a service connection. And to do that, we will go to project setting. Under the pipeline section, you will find an option for service connection. Now, what exactly is a service connection? In Azure DevOps, a service connection is a secure way to connect Azure DevOps with external services, tool, or even cloud provider. It allows pipeline and other services within Azure DevOps to authenticate and interact with external resources. There are several use cases for a service connection, and one of the most common is deploying infrastructure to Azure, which is exactly what we will be doing in this demo. All right, let's continue. Once you click on service connection, you will be taken to a tab where you will see a list of an existing service connection. In some cases, there might not be any, so we will need to create a new one. To do that, scroll down and select Azure Resource Manager, since we'll be using ARM, then click next. And for identity and credential, we'll leave it as recommended. At this point, you'll be prompted to sign into your Azure account. Once you sign in, you'll be redirected back to the configuration page. We're going to leave the app registration as it is, along with the identity tab and credential. For the scope level, we want to use our subscription. And in our case, we have two subscriptions, but you could also restrict access to a specific resource group if needed. In this demo, we won't be making any change there. Now let's give our service connection a name. We will call it Smart App Connection. And once that's done, scroll down to the security section and grant access permission to all pipeline. Then click save. At this point, the service connection will start setting up. Once it's completed, you will see it appear in the list of service connection, and that's it. Okay, with our service connection set up, we now want to validate that it has also been created within Azure portal. So let's switch over to our Azure portal and look at Microsoft Entra ID. Under the Manage section, scroll down to App Registration, where we can view all the applications in our directory. Click on it, and you should see our App Registration service has been successfully created. Now let's switch back to Azure DevOps, where we are going to create a pipeline. This time we are focusing on creating a classic pipeline because it's essential to understand before moving on YAML-based pipeline. To do that, locate the pipeline tab and click create pipeline. However, at this page, you will notice that while the repository configuration for YAML pipeline are available, there is no option for the classic pipeline. To enable it, we need to go back to our organization setting and on the pipeline setting, scroll down until you find the classic build pipeline option. You will see that it's currently disabled, so we need to turn it on. Now let's return to our Azure DevOps project. If you go back to pipeline tab and click create pipeline again, we should now see the option to use a classic editor. So let's go ahead and click that. Okay, once you've opened the classic editor, the first step is to select a source. In this case, we have our theme project, Project Phoenix. If you remember, we previously imported a smart app. Now go ahead and click continue. Next, we need to select a template. We'll start with an empty template. Once that's done, it's time to add a task to this job. Click the plus icon and in the search bar, type Azure CLI. This will allow us to run a command and then click add to include it in the pipeline. Now that the Azure CLI task has been added, go ahead and click on it to configure it. The display name can remain as Azure CLI. For the resource manager connection, we need to select our service connection. Then under script type, we want to choose a share script. For the script location, select inline script. With that setup, we now need to enter our command, since this pipeline is meant to test our service connection and also serve as a way to implement a classic pipeline using the editor. We are going to create a resource group. In the inline script section, we enter the following command: AZ group create, and then dash n for the name, and we are going to call it test dash rg for resource group. Then dash l for the region we are going to use, North Europe, our current region. So this command will create a resource group named test rg in the North Europe region, and once that's done, save the pipeline, click save, and then confirm by clicking save again, and that should complete our configuration. One last thing, we have our pipeline name set as phoenix-ci, but in some cases you may want to rename it. In my case, I'm going to change this to service connection test. Then after renaming it, click save once more and then save again just to confirm. Now we can run our pipeline by clicking the Q button. Here you will see your agent specification under your agent pool. Click run to start the pipeline. Just a quick side note, your pipeline must use a Microsoft hosted agent that is already set up. If you need help setting that up, let me know in the comment and I can walk you through it. Once the pipeline starts running, we can head over to our job view. The first step is checking out our smart app project. Then after that, it will move on to running the Azure CLI, that command that we provided. And finally, we can see that the job is complete successfully. So next, we want to head back to our Azure portal and navigate to resource group. Under this section, you will see a list of resource group, and among them we should now see the test RG confirming that our pipeline runs successfully and created the resource group as expected. Now let's go back, look to subscription. Under subscription, select the one we used for our service connection. From there, navigate to Access Control IAM, and then select Role Assignment. Under Role Assignment, you will see that a contributor role has been assigned to our service connection. This confirms that the permission we set up correctly, And that's it for this walkthrough. I hope you found it helpful. If you have any question or if something wasn't clear, let me know in the comment section. Next, we will learn how to create a Azure YAML pipeline, configure it, and run tests with our imported application. So stay tuned for that. Thanks for watching.